We are the Saturdays.
What you're about to see is an access all areas insight into our sold out headlines tour.
But remember,
what goes on tour
stays on tour.
Yeah! This time on the Saturdays, what goes on tour.
What are you doing?
I'm in the kitchen.
Who's in the band?
We're not four piece, we're five.
Tricky show tonight.
We're at the right airport, right?
I can't remember the words.
Not good, really, to be fair.
This is the tour through my eyes.
First up, here are the other girls with my vital statistics.
Una's a really passionate person, and I think that's amazing to have in the band.
Strong, sturdy legs.
She's one of those people that knows something about everything.
I'm now filming the camera.
She's a strong woman. I think Una will stick to her guns.
400 a day.
She knows exactly what she wants and she goes for it.
I've got a softness for cheese and that's a big problem.
If she believes in something, you will never ever change your mind.
I'm wearing flip-flops with my tights.
Out of all of us, she's very musical. She loves playing her guitar. She loves to write songs.
Mama, mama, ma, mama, mama, ma, mama, mama, ma, ma, Marvel Rush.
Number one, isn't it?
Una loves Ireland. Anything to do with Ireland, she's like, yeah, this is amazing.
I was actually kicked out of Irish dancing class.
The definite night out.
It's actually quite chilled out.
My partner in crime, she loves a party.
Can't be coming in here with a hangover.
I feel like I'm all arms and legs.
I think the girls would probably nearly know me better than I know myself.
Who would have ever thought that Una would become a mask?
What you see is what you get with Una.
My name is Una and I am the little chipmunk.
Okay, thanks girls. Right, back to the tour. This is what happened on the final leg when the Sats rocked Ireland.
So it's very early in the morning and the time has come that we're doing our Irish trip. It's the last leg of the tour. Mark is about to pick me up in about 5 minutes and I'm trying to keep it down because we've got Sleeping Beauty here, look. It's always very special for me when I get to go back to Ireland with the girls. I get really excited. See?
I'm just in the car going to the airport. We've got two shows in Belfast and then we go to Dublin. Really excited, I can't wait.
When we got to the airport, we got the news that Frankie might not make the show.
I just got here and I just heard Frankie's not coming. So yeah, I don't really know what to say.
I'm very sad to hear about Frankie not making the show.
We've only got 3 shows left now. It'd be a shame to do the last shows without her.
We're not a 4 piece, we're 5, so it's not going to feel the same without her.
We were all devastated, but the show had to go on.
Belfast. Here we come.
And look at the beautiful Belfast weather. We must have left the rain behind.
I'm very proud to be Irish and I always get real into my Irish mode when I'm in Ireland and I love to show the girls everything that's Irish. That's great.
Right, starting off cloudy and rainy today in Belfast. Brightening up a little bit later on with a maximum temperature today of 8 degrees. After that though, it's going to get hot. The Saturdays are here.
Here we are.
When we arrived at the venue, it was confirmed that Frankie was not going to make it. Everyone panicked. Could the show work as a 4-piece?
I mean, we haven't got a show with 4. I'll have to speak to Paul Domain or Peter or someone, but it's not good, really, to be fair.
Everyone was feeling a bit down that Frankie wasn't there and she was ill and everything in Belfast. I decided to cheer them up with some brown bread.
So I called Mammy Healy to ask her for her special recipe.
I've got some wheat germ, I've got some buttermilk, white flour, margarine and baking soda.
How do I start?
Well, you start off with the plain flour first.
About 3 handfuls.
A teaspoon of plain soda with it.
Yeah, just one, yeah? So introduce lots of air. We're well mixed in now.
Love a bit of Irish bread, mate.
Thanks, Vanessa. Peter, what do you think?
What are you doing?
I'm in the kitchen.
I can see you're in the kitchen. Who's in the band?
I love my mother's brown bread. It goes with everything.
Keeps your brain as well.
Bit of brain cleaner, anyone?
I need some of lemon because that will make it sour.
This was the only lemon I could find.
Oh, it smells fishy.
Let's hope no one notices.
I'm kneading it now at the moment. Pop that in there. This is what makes it classic brown bread, the cross. I'm going to leave that there to cook in the oven for about an hour. Una's brown bread.
Nobody believed me when I actually came out of the oven and looked decent. Like, did you actually make that? Yeah, it was a success and it was on the menu and I was delighted. I was very proud of it.
Oh, here she is!
Yeah. Oh, yay!
Go on then, dish it out.
And now for the big taste test. Sixth Saturday Marvin popped by to give his verdict.
Very good.
It actually does taste like a cake.
The fact that Una's made it fresh is amazing.
Every time I think of you, I know I got to eat.
I just can't get enough. I just can't get enough.
Nothing like a bit of home cooking to cheer up the troops. The Belfast show was in jeopardy, so we pulled in the big guns. Paul Demain arrived 1 hour to rework the show as a four-piece. Yikes.
Let's go through them one by one. So, okay.
Start of the show.
I've come back up to Belfast to restage because Frankie's ill. So we've got an hour to do it. That's all we have, so it's got to be done. Only time will tell.
Performing as a four is obviously not as good as performing as a five, but we still want to like cancel the show.
Molly, come forward for me. Una, drop back for
yeah,
me.
Yeah, that's fine.
We worked on the routines because the formations are different when it's just four. Otherwise, you should be like going around with a little gap missing all the time, and that wouldn't look good.
Well, tricky show tonight. Yeah. It's really tricky tonight.
And it wasn't just the dance moves we had to change. It was the singing too.
Vanessa should take the chorus of Love Away Life.
We're kind of sharing it all around us, depending on which songs we sing in.
Una's doing Missing You. This Is Love, you're going to do that.
I can't remember the words, because if I don't, I'll be making them up.
Before we knew it, showtime was upon us, and we were all missing Frankie.
We're just going to phone Frankie, because I just want to see how she's getting on. Hello, how are you feeling?
My head and my neck and my arm are
really
bad
pain.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, we miss you here.
I know, it's horrible for. We better go because we're going on in about 15 minutes.
All right, I'll go
to. We're going to do you proud, Frank.
Okay.
Love you.
Bye.
Love you. Bye.
When you're down a member, you have to just pull together so tight and put everything you've got into it because you don't want to let the fans down.
Are you ready to party?
The night was a huge success. Our Belfast fans were amazing and supported us all the way. Thanks, guys.
You keep on missing out the word.
High five! Yeah! High five.
Yeah.
Really well, and we're certainly going to end on a good note, and I've heard good things that Frankie's going to be joining us as well tomorrow, so it'll be all five of us in Dublin. I'll see you tomorrow.
So I'm coming back for the last show in Dublin. All the other girls are already there, so I'm going to fly there on me own and go meet them all.
Me and the other three girls got a warm welcome from Dublin as we arrived at the venue.
Una!
Una! Are you coming to the show tonight?
Yeah, yeah.
Yay! We've been waiting.
Thanks, guys. Nice to see you.
But Frankie was not having such a lovely time.
There's nobody else at the gate. This is what you get for travelling on your own, isn't it? What's the time?
We're at the right airport.
Hurry up, Frankie. We don't want you to miss another show. While we were waiting for Frankie to arrive, we decided to kick back and watch the rugby. Can't think why.
My boyfriend Ben is playing rugby today. He's playing for England. Trying to find a room that's got like nice atmosphere. Wardrobe. Let's see how it's in there.
I'm all about the atmosphere.
Oh, I do like it in here because it all smells nice.
Meanwhile, back at Heathrow, Frankie was winning.
Okay, 84. Not 78. Wonderful. I can't wait to see Frankie.
Of course we've missed you, Frankie. Oh, is that Ben on the telly?
I was watching the game and he was playing very well, and it was half time, so I was like, right, I'm really hungry, so I'm going to nip down and get some food.
Go on, Ben!
Go on,
I thought I was going to get back in time, but didn't he go and score a try while I was going getting my food?
We raced back to watch the replay.
Got to see the replay of it, but I wasn't there first. But the girls made up for it with all their screaming anyway. It was great.
And to top it all off, Frankie arrived at the venue just in time for our final show.
Missed you, Frankie.
Oh, well, it's nice to be missed, isn't it? She's back.
Hooray! Oh, we missed you.
The sets were a five-piece again. After a final rehearsal, the girls decided, being a local, it was down to me to organise our rap party. So I started to phone around for the perfect location.
Hi, yeah, it's Una from the Saturdays. We were wondering if we could maybe get a table there tonight. Well, this is the band, and then I've got like a few family and friends and that kind of thing, so, you know, maybe about 40 people.
Well, maybe I slightly underestimated when I said 40.
Una's family is the biggest family I have ever seen.
Hi, how are you?
My father was one of 15, and I've got 64 first cousins, so that's a lot.
To actually see them. was just unreal. More and more just kept coming in. She was like, in comes another load. So that's my Irish accent.
The meet and greet for the last show, that was our biggest meet and greet, but there were all my massive, massive Irish family.
Cheese.
Just before we went on stage for our final show, Peter popped by the dressing room. Peter, I hope it's good news.
We're going to do 12 arenas in December.
Yeah! When we got that news, we're like, I can't really believe it. And to think that that is then our next step, we're really excited about it.
So just when you thought it was over.
Party was brilliant. It was really fun. It was nice to celebrate the tour. Everyone kind of just let loose. We were dancing all night long.
There are no stories that I can share.
That's right, Vanessa. What goes on tour stays on tour.
Everything is about getting this to be amazing. Whatever it takes.
The Headlines tour has definitely been our biggest tour to date.
Thank you.
I'm scared.
Everyone's freaking out a bit.
My confidence is just sort of something I'm
bored of it now.
How is this happening to us? The screens are not opening.
They need to focus.
Can't believe the people have actually bought tickets to come and see us. There's thousands of people out there.
Every night that we go out there, I just get the most incredible feeling.
I am really living my dream.
Well, looking back on the tour, it's one of the best times of my life.
The shows are so much fun to do.
That we can sell out a tour is just the best feeling.